Did you hear that Mrs. Murphy had been taking French cooking lessons, and she decided she was going to fix one of those French meals for Murphy? So she says, Murphy, I want you to go way downtown, get me a couple of dozen of them big escargot things, nice big juicy ones with the horns still on them. And one of them big long skinny loaves of French bread and a nice bottle of French wine, the kind with the cork in it, not the screw-on cap like you normally get. And she said, I want you back here at 5 o'clock because I'm going to have the dinner on the table at 6. Now, this was at 4 o'clock. So Murphy rushes off downtown and he buys a couple of dozen big, juicy snails, a nice baguette of French bread, a nice bottle of wine. And he's on the way home and poor old Murphy suffered from an awful Irish ailment, alcoholic constipation. He couldn't pass a bar room. So he's on his way past the pub and he hears the sounds of revelry and merriment coming from within. So he goes in to investigate and the first one to greet him is his friend O'Brien. O'Brien says, Murphy, how are you doing? He says, I'm grand, thanks. O'Brien says, how's the wife? Murphy says, she's an angel. O'Brien says, you're lucky, mine's still alive. O'Brien says, did you hear the Americans have put another man on the moon? Murphy says, that's nothing. Ireland has a space program. We're sending a spaceship to the sun. O'Brien says, don't be ridiculous. A spaceship gets anywhere within 1,000,000 miles of the sun, it'll burn up, evaporate, and disappear. Murphy said, ha ha, we're sending it up at night. Murphy looks over to the bar and he sees a couple of guys there he's never seen before. In his local, and he's very curious, decides to find out about them, so he sneaks over and he listens into their conversation. And the first guy said to the second, he says, oh, you have a lovely accent. Where are you from? And the second guy said, I'm from Ireland. And the first guy says, honest to God, I'm from Ireland too. Let me buy you a pint of Guinness. So he buys him one. And the second guy says, well, where in Ireland are you from? And the first guy said, I'm from County Cork. The second guy said, really? I'm from County Cork too. Let me buy you a pint of Guinness. So he buys him one. And the first guy says, well, where in County Cork are you from? The second guy said, I'm from Cork City. First guy says, honest to God, I was born in Cork City. Let me buy you a Bushmills whiskey. So he buys him one. And the second guy says, well, where in Cork City are you from? The first guy said, Grand Street. The second guy says, honest to God, I was born and raised in Grand Street. Let me buy you a Bushmills whiskey. So there they are, buying each other whiskey and Guinness, clapping each other on the back, shaking hands. Murphy turns to the bartender. He says, what the hell's going on here? He says, oh, it's just the Shaughnessy twins. They're drunk again. Anyway, Murphy has a couple of Guinnesses and a couple of Bushmills himself. And he's half in the bag, decides to head home. He sees a guy tinkering under the hood of his car. He goes up, he says, hey, what's the matter? And the guy comes out from under the hood, says, piston broke. Murphy says, yeah, me too. Anyway, he staggers on down the road and he comes to the cathedral. And he stumbles up the steps, falls through the door, lurches down the aisle. Finally, he collapses into a confessional. And there's a priest sitting in the shadows in the back of the church watching this, and he figures that Murphy might need some spiritual assistance. So the priest goes along, sits in the confessional, pulls the curtain behind him, turns to the side, slides the little window back. Remember? He says, may I help you, my son? Murphy says, yeah, have you got any paper on your side? Anyway, Murphy gets out of there in one piece and he's heading home and he looks at his watch and it's 10 o'clock at night, panic-stricken. He was supposed to be home at 5. Gets to the corner of the street and he looks around the corner and the wife is out on the doorstep with the arms folded and the foot tapping. Murphy says, oh my God, she's going to kill me. What can I do? And he has a great idea. He gets the bag of snails, empties them all over the ground in front of him, starts walking behind them going, come on, lads, we're almost there.